on the pain. The only thing that's real.
I actually became a sex offender when I was in my early 20s through an addiction to pornography. And when I was released from prison, I had nowhere to go. Most sex offenders coming out of prison don't have a support network. They don't have family. They don't have friends, because the label itself has such a stigma that a lot of people distance themselves from it.
What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end.
Estamos manejando por la ruta 729. Esto es en el estado de Florida, en Estados Unidos, y vamos camino hacia el condado de Pahokee, justamente porque en ese lugar hay un pueblo que se llama Miracle Village. Miracle Village es un caso bastante particular. Viven alrededor de 400, 500 personas y toda su población está compuesta por ofendedores sexuales. Ofendedores sexuales pueden ser desde violadores, acosadores, abusadores, pedófilos, pornógrafos, en fin, todos quedan agrupados bajo ese nombre. Y vamos a hablar con su fundador para ver qué nos dice sobre por qué lo fundó y cómo ayuda a la sociedad que todos estén juntos en un lugar tratando de llevar una vida lo más normal posible después de que salen de la cárcel. Bueno, acá llegamos a Southeast Main Street, Pahokee, Florida. Estas son las oficinas centrales, lo que tenemos acá alrededor, que es Miracle Village. Acá vive Pat. Pat Powers es el fundador de Miracle Village. Trabaja en este lugar y se ocupa del proyecto desde hace 10 años. Hey, Pat. Pleased to meet you. How are you? You got a little guardian there.
Oh, yeah. This is Max.
Oh, please excuse me.
Come on, Max. Come on.
Got you working.
Oh, yes. I'm reviewing some people. First of all, we get a letter from them. See, here's the letter.
This comes from jail, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
From prison, Suwannee Correctional Institution. Okay, here's the letter. And so then I start to research. I look them up on the internet, find out who they are, what they are. And then from here, we'll then follow up with some phone calls.
Okay.
Okay, to the different sheriff's departments and stuff like that.
These are his offenses, right?
Yeah, here's his offenses, okay? It says sexual battery by juvenile victim under 12, okay? This is the important part. It says he was a juvenile when he did, so he was under 18.
Oh.
He was 13 or 14 years old when he committed this crime, okay?
And sex battery, what is it?
Huh?
Sex battery.
Sexual battery. So he's considered a sexual predator because the victim was under 12.
So he was probably 14, the victim was
13, 12. 14, and so he'll be a sexual predator the rest of his life in the state of Florida.
How many years did he
live? He got 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 years.
La agresión sexual para el estado de la Florida no es necesariamente un ataque violento y carnal. En este caso, hubo consentimiento de la víctima, pero por la edad de la chica, se lo consideró una agresión. Al agresor de 14 años, le terminaron dando 25 de cárcel. Y ahora, lo que le está pidiendo a Pat es un lugar donde vivir.
What happens if this guy comes out and if you weren't here, for example? What happens if Miracle Village didn't exist and this guy comes out?
He'd probably be put out on the street someplace. And then they would arrest him again for failure to register or failure to have a home or an address.
Because it would be impossible for him to find a place to live.
Yep, and they put him right back in jail. We had a place up in Okeechobee, and we got basically thrown out of there. So we started looking around the state, and then we found Pahokee, this place down here. We always prayed that if we came to the right place, God would open the door so wide, we couldn't help but go in. And if it wasn't, close the door so tight. And we had so many doors closed tight. This one just kept opening up wider and wider and wider. And so we had to find some place for the guys.
But why did you start like starting helping people?
Well, I was in prison. I'm a sex offender. Mm-hmm. Okay. And when I got out, I realized that, you know, other guys needed help.
En los años 80, Pat Powers fue condenado a 34 años de cárcel. Era profesor de gimnasia de una escuela secundaria y un grupo de padres lo denunció por espiar a sus alumnos en el vestuario. En el 2003 fue liberado por buena conducta y desde entonces se dedica a ayudar a otros en situaciones similares. Justamente una de esas personas es Brandon, otro de los vecinos de Miracle Village.
You were involved in a case of sex offense.
Yeah, I actually became a sex offender when I was in my early 20s through an addiction to pornography. Uh-huh. And when I was released from prison, I had nowhere to go. I was told while I was looking for a place to go that most of the places I had lived previously were not legal for me to live at because they were close to schools or close to parks. And the statutes here in Florida say that a sex offender cannot live within a certain distance of those schools and parks and playgrounds and things like that.
Let me interrupt you 1 second. So actually, you were considered, and you are considered a sex offender.
Yes.
Because somebody considered you watched too much porn?
No. The statutes here in the States don't make pornography itself illegal, but because I didn't care what I was downloading on my computers, I ended up with child pornography on my computers.
Okay.
And that was my crime. Okay. Was committing child pornography on my computer.
Consuming, not producing it.
Right.
So it's a crime too.
Yes.
So when you were actually going out of jail, you were wondering what.
So I had no place to go.
Yeah.
The state requires that sex offenders be at least 1,000 yards away from any park or playground or school or a place where children congregate. But also you have to consider the registry itself, because the registry is publicly accessible. Any mom, any law enforcement agency, any neighbor can look up in their neighborhood how many sex offenders live in that area and who they are. So you have to consider the neighborhood and find out.
Website, you.
Mm-hmm. All they do is go to the law enforcement's website, type in their address, and it'll show within a certain range who lives in that area that's a registered sex offender. When it was time for me to be released, I literally had no place to go.
Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything.
Estamos recorriendo Miracle Village. Como ven, este era un viejo basurero cuando Pat recién llegó. Y ahora lo que se pueden ver son todas casas muy prolijas. Es un barrio muy tranquilo donde no pasa absolutamente nada. Está habitado por 400 personas. Y son todos ofendedores sexuales. Por suerte, gracias a lo que consiguió Pat, hoy no tienen que poner esos pósters que se obligan en realidad a poner en el estado de Florida, que indican que en cada casa vive un ofendedor sexual. Como acá todos saben lo que hicieron los otros y todos tuvieron su tiempo en la cárcel, acá no hace falta estar indicando que uno es un ofendedor sexual porque es justamente el barrio donde viven todos ellos.
No cualquier delincuente sexual puede vivir en Miracle Village. El trabajo de Pat y su organización es precisamente hacer una investigación de fondo para ver si son potenciales reincidentes o no. Entonces, en caso de ser considerados riesgosos, se les dice que no pueden vivir ahí.
Right there in your computer, you are like doing some background checks.
Yeah, right here what I'm doing right now is here's a person that we got a phone call about, okay? This person got out March 8th, 2018. Okay, and his sister called us and wanted to know what we could, if we could do anything for him. If we could find him housing, work with him. He basically has nothing. He has no, you know, I mean, you take somebody out of society for 24 years and say, okay, go back there.
You do this for free, right? You don't make a living out of this.
No, we don't. We don't get paid.
You don't
Any donations we get go directly to helping the guys get housing and stuff. Okay, this guy here, I had to turn him down.
What was it?
And the reason I had to turn him down, first of all, he's into drugs. Heroin, cocaine, sale, purchase.
Like hard drugs.
Yeah. we can't help him. And we can't put the community at risk. We can't bring a drug dealer in here. We can't bring somebody who we don't know about. We can't just, I mean.
He is getting out of prison on the 1st of April. He was on heroin, but he's clean now. The worst part is that he met the wrong woman that lied about her age, and he ended up becoming a sex offender.
What is his name?
Edward Kubrizak. He's a sexual offender.
Okay.
Yep,
no problem.
And please do whatever you can.
Yes, we will. Okay, 1-3-4-4. There he is. His charges were? Well, they got him, the sex offender failed to comply. They put him back in prison because he didn't register. His was adult sex with a 16 or 17 year old. It wasn't forced. So it was consensual.
Okay, but so there's no
they were under 18, right. So we can help him.
How do you go to jail for having sex with a minor if there was consent and there is no denounce?
In the state of Florida, if you have sex with anyone under the age of 18, we have a young man, Chris Dawson, who has sex with his girlfriend. They've been dating, okay? And she was 15 and he had turned 18 and they got caught, and the cops came and they arrested him. They asked him if he, you know, he said, yeah, we did. So they arrested him.
And he went to jail?
He went to jail. For now they're engaged and they're getting ready to get married and everything.
He's getting married with the same girl
yep.
he went to, recent,
yep.
To prison for?
Yep.
Can you imagine your life after jail without Miracle Village? What it would be like?
Without Miracle Village, at the time that I needed them, I would have lived on the street. I would not have had a support network. I wouldn't have had people to keep me accountable to things like going to group therapy, which is mandated for folks who are on probation. I wouldn't have had a group of people to help me find work. I would have been by myself. And because of that, I would have become desperate. And desperate people commit desperate acts. And I likely would have gone back to jail for something as simple as, I don't know, stealing so that I could feed myself.
Do you feel like satisfied with what you did?
No, because I didn't get the laws, all the laws changed. I want the laws changed where people can be free. They do their time in prison, let them come out like anybody else. Become a citizen, okay? Those that are extremely dangerous don't get out. This is what people don't realize. They get life sentences. So, but they're punishing those that aren't dangerous that might slip through the crack. They say, well, you might slip through the crack, okay? Well, you're gonna punish 1,000 for one? And it's just ridiculous.